Valley. As with the wind of change, Renaissance women sway. Bloodline and grace dancing with our nation's finest strapping sons. Merriment and song, draining out the volley of destiny's cries and growling guns. Ascending the height, hand in hand, out love outrunning the black and tan. Sisters and comrade brothers, both in equal measure taken. Pulses skipped across sheets and sea, as love did bleed as ink. Charm and passion never to fall out of fashion, or so one truly vows to think. Of you, Kitty, he truly was taken. O dearest Kitty, rest easy now from what troubled thee. A patriot's lover's curse of heartache, loss, and taunted wish of liberty. For years mark time, and time marks years taken. So, thank you, folks. Go Margaret. So, as we await the gentleman to join me, I'll just give you a quick spiel on who I am. I don't always look like this every day. I'm a woman of many disguises. So, yes, my name is Deirdre Orme, and I'm the manager here of our Heritage Centre, Knights and Conquests, a community enterprise very much run by the people, for the people. And today we are gathered to honour and celebrate the lives of our people, past and present. And, you know, it's something to be very proud of where you come from. No matter where you're from, always keep that with you. So, yes, I started there with a poem, and that poem was inspired by, of course, our local lady, Miss Kitty Kiernan. And I'm absolutely delighted to let you know, folks, that we are here in the presence of Margot Geraghty's, Geraghty's daughters and son, okay? This gets quite complicated, but they're Kitty's great nieces and nephew. So Larry Kiernan, the man that would have owned that car that Michael Collins was transported around the highways and byways of Longford. So Larry is the granddad of Margaret, Catherine and Connor. So a boule of us to welcome them all back to Granard. So yes, that's a poem I did pin to page there. And it's a woman that was prepared very much to lay down her life for her own true love, the one and only Michael Collins. And of course, Michael, he laid down his life for us all. So it's only just and right that we should gather here today to honour him and celebrate what we have today. And it's amazing if you go inside and you take a closer look at those letters. It's just absolutely fascinating, and it really touches the heart every time I read them. In his own words, how he's recalling how he wished to be there on the moat. And, you know, to look across the Innie, Derivara and Sheelan, and think of Fergus O'Farrell to Mount Nugent, and turning westward, he sees Cairn Hill, where the beacons were lighted to announce the men of Longford that the French had landed in Killala. Isn't that quite amazing? He's writing this on his 30th birthday, and he in negotiations with Winston Churchill. And, you know, Kitty, she was always terrified that something would happen her Michael. And, you know, one of her last letters, it's a fascinating letter, but she was prepared, as I said, to lay down her life for Michael. And, you know, she was terrified that he was putting himself at all kinds of risks. These are her own very worn words. And she just wanted to be there to hold him and be with him. So now, without further ado, look, I started with a poem. I'll finish with a short one, and then we'll get on to the gentleman here beside me. So this one is called Heartland. And yet again, it's inspired by the great love story, greatest love story of this nation. Heartland. Michael, thy words etch upon this heart, remembering a morning shared upon the moat. Salute thee, great rebel leader and statesman, and to Kitty you, her love, fair right and honourable man. And oh, how you just longed to be here, to climb the grassy bank and view the Inny, Derivara, Sheelan and Killin. Hope and vision hand in hand, ascending our daily toil to the heartland. So Gurumila Mahagut folks, I'm going to pass you on now to Cahirlock of Longford County Council and a proud, proud Granard man, Mr. Turlough McGovern.
Thank you, Deirdre, and I'd like to welcome everybody here today on behalf of Cahirlock of County Longford, and certainly a proud Granard person here today. The hairs were standing in my head coming up to town. It's great to see crowds out again. And look, we're so lucky in this town that has great ambassadors like the likings of Eamon Kramer. This car, they wanted in Ballyblaw, and we kept it here for this proud day here in Granard here today. And look, I'd like to give Eamon, he's been working here along with the men's shed and the whole lot for the last couple of weeks, and I'd like to give him a big round of applause. Deirdre here behind me, phenomenal work done behind the scenes and all our crew, and I'd like to thank Longford Pipe Band, of course, and all that comes with it to bring a great bit of an atmosphere here in Granard. And even Jody Sheridan was down the town, and it's a long time since he marched behind the band. So it was great to get that. But come back to what Collins had in the 16th of October, as he wrote about his lovely fiance here, Kitty Kiernan, and we're so proud to have the connections here in Granard. Where I'd love to be on the moat in Granard, where my fiance comes from. Such a line to write and ream off there for the last couple of weeks. I read more about Collins in the last month than I ever knew about him. As such a statesman, it's a credit to have any connection to do. And there's big celebrations all over the country. I suppose the biggest one is in Cork. There's one in Kilkenny. But I think in our own hearts here in Longford, this one would be hard bet. Of course, Deirdre has thanked so many, and she was closely connected with them for the last nearly 12 months. But this man to come up from Cork there this morning at 3 o'clock, Dan Breen, a welcome guest, and such a man to bring up the letters from the Kitty Kiernan's time. And we thank you very much with our heart and soul here from Granard, Dan. And I hope you enjoy your stay here in Granard, and maybe you mightn't go back to Cork at all. With further ado, I'd like to thank everybody for turning out this evening. Such a wonderful occasion here. And I'm certainly one of the proudest men here in Granard. And such a year to be Cahirlock of County Longford. And thanks for all your support. I'm going to hand you over now to this Cork man. And I'd like to thank him very much for bringing us up them letters. The one and only Dan Breen. Thank you.
Hi everyone. I think I'd be called what you'd call the token Corkman. It was a great honour actually driving in the car, and being a Corkman, I felt particularly close to Michael Collins being in that car at some stage. It was an absolute pleasure to be here. We launched our own Civil War exhibition yesterday in Cork Public Museum, and when I told people, oh, are you going to Ballyblaw today? Or are you going, no, I'm going to Granard. And the response, you know, again, I think in all the history of Collins, Granard's connection and Kitty Kiernan tends to be overlooked and forgotten. But I can tell you when I first saw those letters back in 2003, when I first joined in the Cork Public Museum, Granard is written in quite a lot. It's up the top of a lot of the letters. So I was always intrigued, always, where is Granard? What's it like? And today I can finally say I've answered both those questions. It's in Longford, and it's incredibly nice and very welcoming. So I want to thank everyone here for, especially Deirdre, for making me feel welcome. I especially, while I'm here, want to thank her family, who have gone above and beyond to make sure I got here, and that I get home. So Eamon, Barbara, Avril, and Seamus, I think I got your names right. Thank you very much. I'm going to tell you just a little story about the letters and how they actually nearly didn't make it to here today. In 2009, Cork City was very badly flooded. And in the museum, we generally keep everything on the upper floor. But at this particular weekend, we had the Collins letters in the curator's office in the bottom shelf. And the office was completely flooded. Most everything else in the office was destroyed, but the letters weren't. So we do think in Cork that Collins maybe stepped out of the clouds, came down and covered the letters, or maybe even Kitty herself, to make sure that they survived. And thankfully they did. And I am absolutely honoured to bring them up here today. But I would like to announce, when you do see them inside, from tomorrow morning on, all those letters are available online for everyone to look at. We've digitised the entire 300 of them, and they're now online. So if anyone's interested, you can go onto our website, corkpublicmuseum.ie, and you'll see them all there. Now I'm going to be quiet, and which is rare for a Cork man. I'm going to keep my mouth quiet and walk away. But I want to thank you all very much for having me here, and especially to Deirdre and everyone here who works at the Heritage Centre. Thanks very much.
Gormila Mahagut, Dan. Little do you know, you're going to be walking home. The important part was getting you up here, but no, we'll look after you. And thanks very much, Dan, for making it. And look, at you mentioned there that Collins, he must have come out of the clouds to save those letters. I think he's come out of the clouds today. Look at that day he has given us, my goodness, considering the day that has gone before. So yes, there's definitely someone up there looking down. So now I have a very special guest. And, you know, she's been put on the spot here, so she has been. But she's coming up to me. So remember I was telling you about that connection with the Kiernans? Yes. So I have the lady to tell you all. And this is Margaret and Connor and Catherine and family. So Margaret, I'm going to hand over the microphone to you, and you can go through the exact link and tell your tales. Please do. I know I'm after putting you on the spot, but I really appreciate it. And look at it, we couldn't let today go by and knowing that you were there marching along with us without asking you to say a few words. So Gormila Mahagut, Margaret.
So thanks very much, Deirdre, and everyone for organising such a fantastic parade here today. I can't tell you how meaningful it is for us to be back in Granard. I'm Margaret, this is my sister Catherine, and brother Connor, and his daughters as well, Ayla and Fia. And if you'll bear with me as I try to explain the connection that Deirdre's already explained, but the main connection really is via our mother, Margot Geertie, who I'm sure many of you know. Yeah, it's lovely to see the nodding faces here today. And Catherine and myself were visiting Mum today in Laura Lodge Nursing Home. And we grew up listening to the stories of Kitty Kiernan and Michael Collins. And we learned the history piecemeal. And we heard about our grandfather, Larry Kiernan, who is Kitty's brother. And we heard about the Model T and the car. And gradually over time, the whole history started to come together in our head. But, you know, it's learning from our mother's stories, really. And so Kitty was our great aunt. And we heard all kinds of background and foreground history about that I wouldn't dare try to sort of start announcing from the podium. But I just wanted to say how great, on behalf of the three of us today, and on behalf of the whole family and the whole Kiernan family, and on behalf of history, how wonderful it is to be here today. So thank you.
So folks, Gormila Mahagut, and you know something, I had a list of thank yous and they're gone out the window because there's so many people, and looking across the crowd here now and seeing the faces and the people that have helped me out, I don't know, I'd be putting myself at risk if I mentioned one and left out another. But there's some people, I suppose, I do have to welcome into the town. John. John has recently purchased the Greville Arms, and you know he's been very good to us here, and he has given us the loan of some items out of the Greville. And without those items, our exhibition today would be nothing. Another man that has contributed greatly would be Martin Morris, and of course his right-hand woman there, Mairead, thank you so much, Longford Historical Society, Longford County Council, for all the banners and information inside. Now we have some very special items inside, as well as the letters. We have a little pocket watch. Have you seen it? It's the most sweetest thing. And yes, it was given to Kitty Kiernan by the one and only Michael Collins on the occasion of their engagement. It's inside, folks. And there is various items in there. Of course, they were due to get married. And as we all know, around these parts, Sean McKeown was another great man and a great friend of Michael Collins. So he was due to be best man to Michael. It was due to be a double wedding. So Kitty was marrying Michael, and her sister Maud was marrying Garóid O'Sullivan, Michael's cousin. Of course, that wedding didn't happen. But I'm very glad to have Sean McKeown here today. Not the Sean, and he's a few generations behind, but we have Sean McKeown's ceremonial sword inside as well, and I'm very grateful to have that here today. Other items include a Michael Collins's collar, and you know there's a long story to this one, but it was donated to us by Phil Colgan, and his grandmother was a member of Commemoration, and she was a messenger for Michael Collins. So there's a huge story connected to that. The information is inside. There's other items. There's items been handed in as we speak. It's unbelievable what is coming out of the woodwork. And, you know, there's some very rare artifacts inside. Go in, have a look for yourselves, and enjoy the evening. And now, without further ado, I am going to introduce to you the one and only Michael Collins, or Michael Collins, yeah. He's as good as to me. The one and only Matt Levy here. And when you hear Matt sing this song, it says it all. It is the ballad of Michael Collins. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. And nice to be down here for such a great day. And the song was written by Johnny McAvoy many years ago, and a great singer-songwriter. So hope you like this version of the song, anyway. Right? On a far off August day, hold your man and I'm sleigh on the roadside by a hill where flowers grow. So much hay for one so young, who's right and who's wrong. Though a thousand years may pass, we'll never know. Candles dripping blood, they place beside your shoulder. Rosary beads like teardrops on your finger. Friends and comrades standing by, in their grief they wonder why Michael in the round of me you had to go. How an evening twilight came, gently fell the autumn rain. Oh, but you lay still and silent on the ground. As we hung our heads in prayer, in the sorrow and despair, we wondered, was it friend or foe?
who shut you down. Candles dripping blood, they place beside your shoulder. Rosary beads like teardrops on your finger. Friends and comrades standing by, in their grief they wonder why Michael in the hour of need you had to go. Now the flame you held high as you called out to the sky to end the senseless killing and the shame has now passed through many hands and is carried through this land by some not even fit to speak your name. Candles dripping blood, they place beside your shoulder. Rosary beads like teardrops on your finger. Friends and comrades standing by, in their grief they wondered why Michael in the hour of need you had to go. Michael in the hour of need, why did you go?
Thank you very much.